Today we shall talk about the basic procedure of SICS or manual small incision cataract surgery for easy understanding. The surgical technique will be demonstrated with respect to the right eye. Since the surgeon operates from the head end of the patient, this is the superior aspect and this is the inferior aspect. After anesthesia and prepping, a universal wire speculum is inserted to keep the eyelids apart to allow easy exposure for the surgery. It is called universal because it may be used for both the right and left eyes. Here, a superior surgical approach is demonstrated. A superior rectus bridle suture is applied while holding the superior rectus tendon with a dastur superior rectus forceps so as to turn the eyeball slightly inferiorly to maximize surgical exposure. Next is the opening of the conjunctiva or conjunctival peritomy. Using a conjunctival scissors, a fornix-based flap is made, that is, a flap with an incision at the limbus and which is reflected towards the fornix. Bladders are cauterized with a bipolar cautery. The scleral incision is a triplanar incision which is a self-sealing incision, therefore this is a sutureless surgery. The first plane of the triplanar incision is made at 30 to 50% scleral depth, 1.5 to 2 mm from the limbus. The second plane is a scleral tunnel which is carried forward about 1.5 mm into clear cornea, and the third plane is the plane of entry into the anterior chamber. For the first planar incision, three types of incisions can be made in SICS. They are frown, straight and chevron. What do they look like? This is the frown, this is the straight and this is the chevron. The chevron produces the least amount of astigmatism. Here, a frown incision is made with a number 15 blade or a razor blade fragment. A crescent knife is then used to dissect a scleral tunnel to about 1.5 millimeters into clear cornea, that is the second plane of the triplanar incision. The internal width of the tunnel should be greater than that of the external width. A side port incision is useful for extra maneuverability and for easy removal of sub-incisional cortex. It is made with a lance blade temporarily. Capsule staining is optional. Triplan blue is injected into the anterior chamber and washed out after a few to 30 seconds. This stains the anterior capsule, making it more easily visible. This is especially useful in a white cataract. Viscoelastic is then injected to maintain the anterior chamber and to protect the corneal endothelium. Continuous curvilinear capsulorhexis is the preferred method of capsulotomy. A bent 26 gauge needle can be used, in which case it is referred to as a needle cystitome. Alternately, a uterator forceps may be used. Now the anterior chamber is entered with a keratome. This is the third plane of the triplanar incision and the incision is extended on either side to complete the internal opening of the tunnel. The hydro procedures are employed to free the nucleus from the rest of the lens and reduce it in size to enable easy removal from the small incision. Hydro dissection is performed by injecting balanced salt solution just under the rectus margin. The fluid travels and separates the nucleus from the rest of the cortex and capsule. In hydrodelineation, BSS is injected into the mass of the nucleus to separate the soft epinucleus from the harder inner main nucleus. The nucleus is then prolapsed into the anterior chamber using a Sinsky hook. The nucleus is then removed from the eye with the help of a wire rectus. You can see the same thing in the operating view. Cortex is then removed with the help of a Simcoe irrigation aspiration cannula, while simultaneous irrigation is done with BSS. Viscoelastic is injected and a posterior chamber IOL is then placed in the capsular bag and rotated into place with the help of a Sinsky hook. Viscoelastic is removed, side port is closed by stromal hydration, the conjunctiva is reapposed with the help of a bipolar cautery. An antibiotic and steroid is then injected subconjunctival. So that's it for today. See you in the next video.